Welcome to the Fit Small Business Xero Training Course. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to create a balance sheet report in Xero. To follow along with me, log into your Xero account now or click the link below this video for a free 30-day trial of Xero. You can also click this link to access our full Xero course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. The balance sheet report shows the assets, liabilities, and owner's equity of your business as of a point in time. For example, as of December 31st, 2016. The balance sheet report provides you with the net worth of your company, which in other words shows what your business owns, known as assets, versus what you owe to others, known as liabilities. Depending on the results of this report, you may be able to attract potential investors, or secure a business loan from your bank or financial institution. Similar to the income statement, which we discussed in the previous lesson, your balance sheet will only be as accurate as the information you have entered into Xero. Therefore, you must do a good job of entering all invoices, bills, credit notes, and banking transactions into Xero in a timely manner. We recommend at least monthly, if not more often. Click the links below to access our lessons on invoices, bills, credit notes, and banking transactions. By staying on top of entering all of your business transactions, you will always have an up-to-date balance sheet report that you can review monthly and provide to potential investors. Reviewing your balance sheet on a monthly basis has the following advantages. You'll be able to identify assets, liabilities, or equity transactions that have been categorized to the wrong account. You'll be able to catch missing assets or liabilities which could cause inaccurate financial statements. And you'll be able to take proactive steps to improve your overall net worth. To create a balance sheet report in Xero, from the Xero dashboard, you want to click on Reports and then select All Reports. The balance sheet report is located in the Financial section. As you can see here, there are two balance sheet reports. Xero has redesigned several reports, and the balance sheet is one of those reports. For the purposes of this lesson, we will discuss the new balance sheet report, which has the new button to the right of it here. You can easily add a report to your favorites by clicking the star to the left of the name of the report. So as you can see right now, the old balance sheet report was a favorite report. So what we'll do is we'll click that star to remove that from the favorites list, and we'll actually add our new balance sheet report to the favorites list. Now, when you add a report to the favorites list, what that does is when we go back up to the reports menu, instead of clicking on all reports, we'll be able to go directly to the report that we'd like to run. And so we'll be able to go down to our balance sheet report and run it directly from there. So let's go ahead and run our report. In the next screen, we'll go ahead and select the date range that we'd like to run the report for. So from the drop-down here, you can actually select one of the preset dates here from the list, or you can click Custom and then select a different date that you'd like to use. Be sure to click the Update button to refresh the report. So here is a sample balance sheet report for our fictitious company, Acme Web Pros Plus. The balance sheet report can be exported to a PDF, Excel, or Google Sheets. Just click the Export button and then make your selections here. You can also save a report as a draft, published, or custom. The draft option allows you to create a balance sheet report that you or someone else can make changes to later on. You might create several draft balance sheet reports before you are ready to publish them. The published option is used to save reports when you are finalizing the books for the month or the year. A published report will not change if for some reason the information in the system has changed or updated in some way. You can only publish reports if you have the advisor user role. Click here to access this lesson. And finally, a custom report. You want to use this option to save the format of the balance sheet report so that you don't have to recreate it each time you run the report. Xero will ask you if you would like to make this template your default. We'll show you how to save a custom report format in the next section. Similar to the income statement, there are three primary ways you can make changes to the balance sheet report. You can change the report title. You can change the report settings, or you could change the layout and format of the report. You could change the title of most reports in Xero. To do this, just hover your mouse near the title of the report, and to the right, you'll see a link that says Edit Title. If you click that link, it opens up that box to give you the option to edit the report title as you choose to. The options available in the report settings will depend on the type of report that you are running. The report settings option for every report in Xero will always be located to the right of the date range section. Let's take a look at the report settings options that we have available for our balance sheet report. So the options that we have here are the ability to compare our report to previous periods. So for example, if we run this report and we say we want it as of the end of last month, and if we chose to do this as of the previous period, then what'll happen is we'll have a report that shows a column as of the end of last month, June 30th, 2017. And then we'll also have another column that shows us the previous period, which would be the end of May. Accounting basis. In general, most businesses use the cash method of accounting. However, Xero allows you to use either method, accrual or cash, to run your reports. Please note the default reports are run using the accrual method of accounting. If you prefer not to have decimals shown on your report, you can go ahead and remove this check mark here that says show decimals. And then finally, tracking categories. If you have set up tracking categories in Xero, then you can filter this report to show all tracking categories that you have set up, or just certain ones. Click the link below to learn more about how tracking categories work. So in this example, we currently have all tracking categories selected. We could remove all and just select specific ones if that's what we'd like to do for this report. And then once you've made all the changes to your report, you want to be sure and click the update button so that the data on the report will refresh. The Edit Layout Designer tool allows you to customize your reports as follows. It gives you the ability to add rows or columns to track totals or notes. It allows you to revise account groupings. You can rearrange rows and columns by dragging and dropping them. And you can change formulas. So Acme Web Pros Plus would like to add a footer to the bottom of their balance sheet report. So let's go ahead and walk through the steps to add a footer to this report, and then we'll save the report as a custom report so that it will include the footer each time we run our balance sheet report. At the bottom of the report, you'll see a button that says Edit Layout. Go ahead and click that button to launch the Edit Layout Designer. So here is our Edit Layout Designer template. At the very top, we've got the toolbar. So you can use the toolbar to format text, add a schedule to the report, add a footer to the report, add a row, or add a column. So we wanted to go ahead and add a footer to this report. So we'll click the footer icon here, which takes us to the very bottom of the report where we can actually type in the footer. After we've typed our footer information here, we can actually format it. Over to the right, we've got an option to bold it. We can italicize it, and we can even highlight the text. Once you're satisfied with the footer information, you want to go ahead and click the Done button over here to the right. And then we will go back to our report, and our new footer should be here. And here it is. And so now, if we want to go ahead and make this our default balance sheet report, which means that each time we come in to run the balance sheet report, it will go ahead and provide us a comparison to the previous period that we're running our report for. And it will also show us this footer at the bottom of the report automatically. Then we want to save this report as a custom report. So to save this report as a custom report, you should name it so that you know it's your custom report and not the default report in Xero. So make some type of notation to the report name. This won't show up anywhere. This is just so that you know this is your report. And then you can also make this report your default, so that, as I mentioned, each time you come in to run this balance sheet report, it will be the default balance sheet report that will run. And so we'll click our save button to make that change. And that's it. So that wraps up the lesson on how to create a balance sheet report in Xero. To access our full Xero course or any of the other lessons in this series, click this link. You can also find a link below this video for a free 30-day trial of Xero. If you have feedback about this course or if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Also, don't forget to subscribe.